Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The third of Ramadan is a special day for believers, because on this day, the Queen of Paradise, the beloved daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, Sayyida Tayyiba Tahira Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha, passed away. Her name is Fatima, title Zahra, and then also she has numerous titles, including Tayyiba Tahira, pure and the purified one. That she is herself pure, and she also purifies those who love her. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants them the sweetness of Iman. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam told us in numerous ahadith the special status she has in Islam. I'm just going to mention a couple of ahadith, and then inshallah some of the lessons that we can learn when we talk about Sayyida Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha and the relationship that the Prophet had with her. Firstly, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Fatima bid'atun minni, that Fatima is part of me. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is you know, helping us to understand the how much love he has for her, that he is saying that she is part of me. That means that she is indeed, she has special status in the sight of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Then there are some other hadiths that tell us that Allah's Messenger says that those who dislike Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha, they will be disliked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam used to have such a special relationship that there are so many hadiths that tell us that every time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would leave Medina Munawwara, his city, to visit another city, the last house that he would visit would be the house of Sayyida Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And the first house that he would enter as soon as he would come back to Medina Munawwara, he would come to Sayyida Fatima Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha's house. You know, so in a way, as if that he didn't want to be away from her for too long. So he visited her as the last person, and he visited her as the first person when he came back to Medina Munawwara sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. In another hadith mentioned in Tirmidhi, Ummul Mu'mineen, mother of the believer, Sayyida Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam loved her so much that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam would be sitting in a majlis and Sayyida Fatima would enter the room, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam would stand up and would welcome her and then place her either in the same place as he was sitting or right next to her. And this is in that culture where people didn't really value women. Actually, there was infanticide of young girls was common in that culture. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in that culture showed that how much he loved his daughter. So much so that there are other hadiths that tell us that when Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha was asked, who did the Prophet love the most? She replied that he loved his daughter Fatima Zahra the most. So this is in a way inspiration for us, that now to this day we still have in some of our communities, in our culture, that we do not value girls in the same way as we value boys. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Hijr, Allah says, وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْفَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. In Surah Nahl, in 14th part, Allah says, وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْفَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. That when you give them the news that you are going to have a daughter, his face darkens. وَظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْفَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. And he tries to hide his displeasure at that. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to say that how he hides his displeasure. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam changed that culture. The Arab culture at that time, that they didn't treat men and women in the same way. They didn't treat boys and girls in the same way. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by by visiting his daughter Fatima Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha constantly, and then by asking her to sit next to him or in a you know, whenever she visited, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed that how much he wanted to change that culture. And then there's so many hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the one who raises three daughters, you know, he raises according to Islam, looks after them, cares for them, provides for them, you know, treats them with respect, treats them with love, treats them with dignity, on the day of judgment, he, that person and myself would be next to each other. You know, that person will be granted a place in paradise. Then there is another man stood up and said, how about Prophet, what if someone only has one daughter? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even he would be granted a place in paradise. Obviously, then first we go to two daughters and then moving on to one daughter. In a way, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching us, that no matter what you, how many daughters we have, if you treat them equally, if you show love to them as you would love your boys, if you help them to do well in their worldly matters as well as in their matters of the next world, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep you under the shade of His mercy. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He grants us the love of Sayyida Fatima Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha, but also at the same time that He enables us to understand and act upon the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Please do recite Surah Al-Fatiha and present the reward of all of this to Sayyida Fatima Zahra radiallahu ta'ala anha, the Queen of Paradise, Sayyida Ahlil Jannah.